Welcome everyone to another video, and in this video we're going to be featuring battles in the Open Master League using a triple steel team. Steel super strong in Open Masters, especially with the rise of Dialga. So let's go ahead and get started with the battle, leading Metagross into Garchomp. Obviously Garchomp super bad for triple steel. It's actually Mudshot too, so that's actually not the greatest situation here. But if they have this is actually pretty terrible, but so we'll see if it's gonna be they do earth power, which is actually terrible. Okay, obviously gonna come to extra. Oh, okay. Oh my gosh, this is a mud slap Excadrill. Okay, good timing on the throw. Really need them not to shield this drill run. They don't. Okay. Okay, kind of need them not to shield this drill run again. It would live the drill run. Let's see. And technically you'd live the mud shots as well. Okay. See what they do here. They throw the earth power, but no debuff. Okay, all right, let's see if they shield. Okay, they don't. Okay, gonna switch right away. Oh man, the classic master premier class, master premier. This is fine though. They go for the meter mash, that's totally fine. Gonna wild charge. They need seven more for the, okay, yeah, this is great. Gonna mirror shot. This doesn't really matter here. This is GG. Once you land the one wild charge, it's gonna be more than enough to be able to take it out. And then even, you could definitely land in our wild charge and be able to mud shot down afterwards, and the attack dropped, and it's GG. Very nice play. I think that Metagross is underleveled. I actually think that's just a strictly level 40 Metagross there. So all right, we're gonna have a Metagross into Yveltal. Okay, this is actually pretty tough as well. It's gonna go straight into Excadrill. Go, whoa, okay, they come to Zacian. Okay, I actually thought it was gonna be a Sylveon there, but gonna throw the drill run. Two drill runs will KO. So just gonna straight up take the shield, which I think is the appropriate play. Winning switch is nice, and not, I think you need shields more though. So gonna let it go and then wait the clock out, and then, okay, not gonna wait the clock out, but that's fine. I think you no shield this and then farm down. Yeah, they're gonna close combat. That's about half. You meter mash this or switch here, that's good too. Okay, they come to Metagross. Oh, okay. Now this is a more appropriate level Metagross, so. Shield this, yeah, makes sense. Okay, they're at 100. Gonna wild charge, and interesting. So you can see here the mirror shot shouldn't KO. So but let's see if they shield. They do. Okay, that's great. Gonna wild charge. Okay, maybe build up. Okay, that's fine though. Can just switch here in meter mash. Switch in meter mash. Technically the Yveltal can farm and make this like a pretty close game, but this meter mash will do a lot of energy. Okay, and then close game here. It'll be close. But I think this is gonna be okay, yeah. Able to get to the wild charge and take out the Yveltal. That's all Yveltal we wrote. All we wrote. I don't know what I was going with that particular pun. Okay, Snorlax, kind of tough lead again. Gonna go straight to Excadrill. You're gonna win CMP regardless, so. Okay, looks like they're building up. I think they're waiting for the Excadrill to throw, and then they're gonna superpower. Yeah, it makes sense, right? Because otherwise the drill run would do even more. They body slam bait though. Okay, they come into Zacian, so they're at one right now, so should be able to get the second drill run off because they're only four away. yeah, should be able to get the second drill run off right before they get there. This might even be desync CMP, which actually would be really good in this situation. Okay, nope. You gotta let it go. Okay, gonna shield, okay. And then gonna bullet punch down. Okay, I'm pretty sure the Snorlax has Earthquake though. Otherwise, they're kind of weak to Giratina. Let's see though. Gonna be able to throw the Meteor Mash. They shield. Yeah, let's see here. Yeah, there's EQ. EQ made total sense, especially once they threw the Body Slam and then they showed. Okay, interesting. They Body Slam. This definitely won't KO. But we'll put it pretty low. Okay, gonna switch it right away. Oh man. Tokus into Magnezone. That's definitely a GG. They definitely did not. Snorlax double fairy. Very interesting team. I think they only sent me three battles from this set. But that's totally fine. Get a Minfu encounter. Okay, right. We're going. I believe this is actually the first set they wanted to send me. The second set, obviously, they're 28-10. Maybe they just started recording. We're gonna see how this is gonna go. Obviously, the queues in open are pretty crazy. So Magnezone as the third steel is interesting. Oftentimes you see like Malmetal, but maybe like Magnezone helps you with the Zacian matchup better than Malmetal. Okay, Ho-Oh is very bad. Gonna, oh my gosh, okay, didn't switch out right away, but that's fine. And that's okay. Okay, gonna have to shield. The Earthquake. Okay, they're gonna be able to farm down. It's kind of rough. Very rough. Oh man, that's even worse. Even worse. Okay, obviously come to Magnezone. Have to shield this. Do two more than throw. Okay, that's fine. Got that desync because they got the extra spark through. Okay. And okay, gonna go into Lugia. Okay, gonna go with Yveltal. Okay, this actually, the thing is like, okay, can live this. We'll definitely live this. Need to survive one Snarl. Need to survive one Snarl. Oh, able to survive one Snarl. Okay, and this Lugia really can't do much to Magnezone, and as well lose CMP. Unless it has Hydro Pump, the Aerial Blast is double resisted. So you just basically built a 2 and then you win CMP versus it. So they should Aerial Blast here. If they have Hydro Pump, that's absolutely insane. No, they have Aerial Blast. This doesn't do that much. And able to land the Wild Treasure. Really, the only way Lugia could win this matchup is if it predicted when they were going to throw the Wild Charge. And CMP tied with the Magnezone, right? It was really the only potential win gone, because Magnezone wins CMP in two KOs. So that's like, I'm not entirely sure that like almost anyone in the world could do that. This is obviously very bad. You can go straight to Excadrill. It's actually kind of okay. They come into Zacian. Kind of want shields more than switch, because you want them to come back into okay, threw a 2 there, kind of weird timing. I like this play. They play roughed. Are you serious? Do they play rough Wild Charge? There's no way they have close combat for sure. I think you let this go. you let this go, then you bullet punch down. They'll get a close combat off. With, oh, they don't. Okay, this is good. Hopefully they come. They probably have toe kiss in the back. Definitely. Okay. It's gonna be. It's actually. Extra bullet punch in. Even they bait here, I think you make it to the Meteor Mash. Calls the bait. That's actually kind of insane there. Okay. And okay. They got the boost too. That's crazy. Okay. Gonna switch. Oh, the CMP. Perfect. Let it go. Let it go. And then show me the Togekiss or Sylveon in the back. Okay. Yes. This is perfect. Gonna farm up a little bit here. Gonna throw the mirror shot first. They try to lag out the magma zone. But this is gonna be a GG. Okay. I have no idea how much this mirror shot does. I don't know why my video screen is lagging. Yeah, the wild charge is definitely gonna be enough to KO. But it makes sense because I don't think one wild charge would KO the Togekiss from full in open. So it makes sense to mirror shot first and get the debuff, then go for the wild charge. Not that it really mattered at that point in time. So all right, we're gonna have Metagross into Zacian. This is exactly where we want to see it. Let's see it. They're probably gonna okay go to Magna Zone. Okay, I like them building up the energy up to the earthquake. You let this go. If they hydro pump, good on them, but they're definitely gonna aeroblast. And then you basically do seven and throw. Okay, threw at five. So now they're one away from the... I'm not sure this mirror shot will KO, but let's see. It does definitely does not. Now you have to shield this. And then farm down. It's okay, though. I like this play, trying to CMP tie with the Zacian. I'm assuming the Zacian is going to try to snarl down. Okay, gets the mirror shot off, which is nice. Let's see if they shield. They do not. Going to try to bullet punch down. Going to let it go, preserve the shield. It's an Yveltal. Okay, that was actually a good decision. They threw it two. Again, like throw it at one, it's probably a little bit more optimal, but they're probably going to do, they're going to have to throw, yeah, try to CMP tie. But again, they're probably going to look to snarl down. Oh, can definitely get it off. Okay, so this should be okay. They're obviously going to go for the farm down. And I think you force them to throw into zone. Or, yeah, force them to throw in zone. Perfect. This is actually very ideal. And then there's no way they can win. They Dark Pulse. And this is game over. If they would have snarled down zone, still kind of an iffy matchup because I don't think they would be able to. They actually don't have Focus Blast. And they actually Hurricane BM the Excadrill. So nothing to actually worry about there. So interesting choice. To have Hurricane, I guess, like, not entirely sure. Gonna have Metagross into Dialga. So I think you just Shrey EQ. You don't shield. Okay, gonna go for the bait. Let's see whether or not they shield. They do, okay. Let's see, normally they Iron Head, but they Draco would okay. Should be able to still beat them to the EQ. See if they want to go down two shields to zero. Not two shields to one, I should say. They come into Mewtwo. Very interesting. Should be a CMP tie to the Shadow Ball. Okay. Okay, I like this play. Yeah, they're gonna get six. Okay, they're waiting for the Magna Zone to throw first, which makes sense, and then they're probably gonna Shadow Ball. We'll do a lot. And very confident. Gonna try to CMP tie. I'm not. Or they're gonna try to snarl down. Okay. You let this go. Yeah. And then you just can just mirror shot. Okay. Very nice. And this is a wrap. Yeah. There's nothing that they can do. They even lagged a little bit there, but that was totally fine. Very nice play. And this triple steal is exactly. That's an example of where Magazone damage definitely came in handy. I'm actually a little bit surprised that there was no shield on the Mewtwo. And then very nice switch by the opponent. I like how the Wong Kenny in this case actually elected to go over in case they wanted to CMP tie to try to get the extra spark through. But when Notice could get the free wild charge and switch out, and then the no shield was really nice. All right, we're gonna have Metagross into Dialga. They come into Mewtwo. This is okay. You can definitely live a Shadow Ball. It's just depending on whether or not you want to shield it. Okay, yeah, I like this play just because it'll force them to throw another Shadow Ball, and they'll be able to live the Shadow Ball. And okay, gonna immediately switch. Okay, I like that play. Definitely let it go. Let's see what they want to do. They no shield. Probably just wild charge the Dialga, and that way they get less farm. I'm worried that there's a Kyogre in the back though, but this is if this was classic, I would be worried about. Let's see though, might be an oh my gosh, it is a Kyogre. Okay, well, my instincts did not lead me wrong. Definitely switch. God, that's so terrible. My instincts did definitely not lead me wrong there. I was like, if this is classic, it's for sure a Kyogre in the back. Okay. Needs to get to two, right? So, oh man, I had to try to deny there. I think that's the right play, but honestly, one more waterfall would have KO'd anyways. And there's no way they're gonna get to the move in time. I was like, man, that's rough here. That's also why the Magnezone is better than the Malmetal, because it has a better matchup versus that's gonna be the end of the battle. So a really nice triple steel team finishing off with a shiny Virizion. Anyways, I'm gonna leave there. If you like to see it, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see everyone in the next.